we had to do was beat the worst team in the region, which was Trinidad and Tobago.
The U.S. fell to the 99th ranked Trinidad and Tobago team. I mean, they were near triple-digit ranked. And the U.S. loses them with a World Cup berth on the line.
Population 1.3 million.
It's a national embarrassment. I mean, we're the greatest country on the planet Earth. We're the richest country in the world. We have all the requisite resources, etc. But we can't even make the World Cup. It's an absolute disgrace on an international and global level. And the United States soccer team should be ashamed of itself, right?
Should we be surprised that when they show up in Trinidad and Tobago, they take this game as if it's already done? Well, it's not done. It's not done. You can talk all you want. You can speak all you want. You can complain about the conditions in Trinidad and Tobago all you want, but you got to perform on the day. If I could use a term to describe the United States last night, it was blinded arrogance. A team that shows up and thinks, well, look, it's us. It is the United States. We're going to show up here, and just because we are who we are, things are going to happen.
This is how bad Trinidad and Tobago is. They've won one of nine games in this round of qualifying. They'd already fired two coaches. They had punted on qualifying. Not only were they eliminated, they weren't even calling up their veteran players. They didn't have a guy over 29 years of age in this group. I mean, it was perfectly set up. They left their star forward at home. They had their other best player who was suspended for the game. The U.S. literally couldn't have asked for anything better.
And we blew it.
So from the onset, it just never looked like they were comfortable. They never were consistent. They were up and down the entire time.
This was a Trinidad reserve side who had nothing to play for, who were the worst team in the Hex, who hadn't won in nine matches. How does this, how can this possibly happen? How can the U.S. go there and lose? We were in disbelief at how lackadaisical, how no urgency in the U.S. at all. It seemed like they were going through the motions in a must-win match. The lack of urgency, the looking for others to bail them out.
The truth of the matter is that this is a team, this group of players that has a history that whenever they get challenged, whenever they get punched in the mouth, whenever they get in a way in which a team gets in their faces, they're not able to respond. They haven't been able to respond.
There were players asking, what are the other scores in the other games, instead of worrying about that game, that moment.
Talk about how this happens. You talk about the third string Trinidad and Tobago national team that all of a sudden had something to prove, because the U.S. soccer as a whole, again, from the federation, through the media, through the coach, through the players, looking at Trinidad and Tobago as a little backwater nation, bottom of the Hex, with nothing to prove, unable to play this game. Come join us watching the World Cup next summer.
When you look at Costa Rica playing, when you look at Panama playing last night, at Honduras playing last night, it matters to them. It's life and death to them. You see the emotion with which they play. You see what it means to them to make it to the World Cup.
It's not only one of the worst results in American soccer history, it's one of the worst performances. If you watch that first half hour, I cannot imagine being in a game where you're the team with a World Cup ticket on the line, and you show up and you play with that little intensity. I mean,
I've never seen less urgency. I've played on co-ed rec teams that had more urgency than I was stunned at how dead they looked in the second half. Stunned.
And EB, it was worse in the first half. And all of the guys, the traveling press, we were looking at each other like, do they not know what's on the line?
Happened because I think everybody watching that game expected in the second half, once Pulisic scored, for them to kick on, for them to get together, to realize, right, okay, we've got 40 minutes now to get this second goal.
Dan, I think the hard part for me, though, is why does it take 48 minutes to get to that point? I think that's a difficult aspect.
The U.S. played like they were sleepwalking in the first half and trailed 2-0.
I will pose a question. Does it matter that much to the U.S. players? Because it certainly didn't seem like it when you see the performance.
There's 11 players that step on the field to play. Now, we usually sit here and talk about the shape of the team, the ability, all that stuff. Listen, a large part of the game is between your ears. It's strength of character. It's a mental toughness that when things are not going well, that you can do something about it. The U.S.
team, that for me does not have that strength of character. They simply do.
Listen, players have to take responsibility. At the end of the day, players have to take responsibility. At the end of the day, when you step on to play, it's you do your job. You make sure you do your job. And if everybody does that, then you'll be fine. But if everybody starts passing the buck, and that's what they all did, because not one of them, pretty much, other than Pulisic with a goal, nobody stood up. Nobody.
Unacceptable.
All they had to do was draw or beat the bottom team in the league, Trinidad and Tobago, who has a population of about 1.3 million, playing in front of what it looks like a high school stadium with about 25 fans, looked like the Etihad, and they could not even conjure up that result. They go 2-0 down.
This is as embarrassing as humanly possible.
And it is my point indeed. What history of success, of recent success, does this group of players have to have that arrogance, to have that feeling that it's okay, that it's all sorted out? No, because over the last couple of months, these have been real results. You lost at home to Costa Rica. You barely drew away to Honduras on a late goal. Then you come home, you get the 4-0 against Panama, and it's all resolved. That's it. It's game, set, match. It's over. It's not over. And it's not over simply because you, as a team, haven't proven that it's over.
I don't want to hear excuses. I don't want to hear them. There is no excuse. That is as humiliating as anything could happen to this country's soccer program.
Look at last night. There were 27 scenarios. 27. Only one had the United States, not at least in the playoff, and that's the one scenario that happened.
This team right now, the personality of it all is soft, and it's a team that does not deserve to be in the World Cup, because if you don't beat Trinidad and Tobago, if you don't draw against Trinidad and Tobago when you need to do so, you don't deserve to be in.
All we had to do was get a draw. That's it. And now it's over, and the U.S. will miss the World Cup, which is the biggest egg on the face of this national team program and U.S. soccer of all time.
Our misery train is going a different track, and that is not towards Russia. It's towards the nearest bar to drown our sorrows. Scotland will be there, Netherlands will be there, and now the US men's national team will be there after easily the darkest day in US soccer history.
So 2-1 there, driven across towards the penalty spot, tips up and in, and Winchester, not even sure how he did it. It's a trick shot of sorts, but it loops over Tim Howard and Trinidad and Tobago in front.
A game just, you know, a few days ago, and it seems to be affecting the players.
Long distance blast, and it's Alvin Jones! One for the legend books! Oh my! His first Trinidadian goal, and he might as well retire right now.
What was supposed to be a celebration is now, I don't even know what to say. It's terrible.